Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. This is the second video on programming in Java. So here we are discussing about structured oriented programming and object oriented programming. We will discuss few concepts related to structured oriented programming and object oriented programming. So now we are discussing about what is object oriented programming and features of structured oriented programming, features of object oriented programming language, advantages of object oriented programming, disadvantages of object oriented programming, and differentiate between object oriented programming languages and structured oriented programming languages. So already we discussed in the first video that object oriented programming is a methodology, not a technology. So methodology means preparing the rules and technology uses the methodology instead of writing programming languages. So object-oriented programming is a new way of approaching the job of programming. Approaches to programming have changed dramatically since the invention of the computer in order to accommodate the increasing complexity of programs. Object-oriented programming takes the best ideas of structured programming and combines them with powerful new concepts that encourage you to look at the task of programming in a new light. Object-oriented programming allows you to easily decompose a problem into subgroups of related parts. Then you can translate these subgroups into self-contained units called objects. All object-oriented programming languages have three things in common: objects, inheritance, and polymorphism. Coming to the features of structured-oriented programming, emphasis is on algorithm rather than data. Programs are divided into individual procedures, also called as functions, that perform discrete tasks. Processes are independent of each other as far as possible. Coming to the second part, actually the project is divided into modules, and the modules are divided into functions. This is the skeleton followed in structured oriented programming. Procedures have their own local data and processing logic. Most of the functions share global data, and data move openly from function to function. If you declare it as a global variable, it can access anywhere in the program. Emphasizes top-down approach. It follows from top to bottom. Project can be broken up into modules and programs are independently. So what I said, the project is divided into modules and modules are divided into functions. So whenever we are integrating this, the modules are taking responsibility of handling the entire project. Maintenance of a large software system is tremendous in cost. Whenever we are maintaining a large project, it is a very costly. So coming to the features of object-oriented programming languages, emphasis is on data rather than procedure. Programs are divided into what are known as objects. Already we know what is an object. Data structures are designed such that they characterize the objects. Functions that operate on the data of an object are tied together in the data structure. Data is hidden and cannot be accessed by external functions, and objects may communicate with each other through functions. Follows bottom-up approach. Why? Because it follows from bottom to top. In reverse direction it follows. Why? Because the classes are defined in the top layer and the main class is defined in the last, and in the main class we are calling the objects automatically, the class respective classes will be accessed. So similarly, the advantages of object-oriented programming. Through inheritance, already we knew the concept of inheritance, the mechanism of deriving a new class from already existing class. Through inheritance, we can eliminate redundant code and extend the use of existing. Already we are giving the examples of versions. It gives some more logical impact. Information hiding means data abstraction, and data abstraction increase reliability and helps the programmer to build secure programs that cannot be involved by code in other parts of the program. Dynamic binding increases flexibility by permitting the addition of a new class of objects without having to modify the existing code. Inheritance coupled with dynamic binding enhances the reusability of a code, thus increasing the productivity of a programmer. Many object-oriented languages provide a standard class library that can be extended by the users, thus saving a lot of coding and debugging effort. If it is possible to have multiple instances of an object to coexist without any interfaces, it is easy to partition the work in a project based on objects. Here, using object-oriented programming, everything should be divided into an object and we are communicating the object very easily. So the disadvantages of object-oriented programming: it is not suitable for small programs where functions can give more accurate and quick results. It requires complicated spade work before object-oriented program becomes fully operative. Creation of object libraries and its maintenance is a tough job, requires the master over the software engineering and programming methodologies. The person knows software engineering and programming methodologies, then only he will be implementing the concept of OOPs. Benefits only in long run while maintaining large software projects. It is suited for large softwares, not for small softwares. Now, the differentiate between object-oriented programming languages and structured-oriented programming. Structured-oriented programming is also called as procedure-oriented programming, and we are comparing with object-oriented programming. Already we know that emphasis is on doing things. Here, emphasis is on data rather than procedures. Programs are divided into small things known as functions. Programs are divided into what are known as objects. Data move openly around the system from function to function, here from external functions. Debugging process is very difficult, here very easy. Follows top-down approach, follows bottom-up approach. Most of the functions here, global data, the data of an object can be accessed only by the functions that are associated with it. Thank you.